சத்யபாமா இன்ஸ்டிடியூட் ஆஃப் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் டெக்னாலஜி சென்னை.
Lloyd Law College, the only college nurturing the legal skills through 20 plus skill development programs, trial advocacy cell, moot court, debate society and many more. Earn a career, not just a degree.
It's always fascinating to learn how quickly we are able to pivot when we are faced with a crisis. Moving on to our next session, here we have with us Careers in Management. What does the future look like? Please welcome Mr. Sachin Gupta, Chancellor of Sanskriti University. Many thanks for joining us, Mr. Gupta. Let me begin by asking you about, with the pandemic, it's pressed the reset button on a lot of ways in which we transmit knowledge, right? So I want to understand, how have you, for an engineering college, what are the things that you've implemented to make sure that your students are, more adept and they have the skills for a post-COVID world?
I think after this post-COVID, and we are in the phase of COVID also, and pandemic too, which is happening phase two, I think we need to understand further new growth areas in the field of engineering and what is the new ways of business that we're working in, the new technology, like it is very much in the work from home, artificial intelligence, 24/7 availability, global village, virtual market, virtual currency, virtual language, virtual laws and regulations, and virtual platform. This is a new way of working in today's scenario. So I think our students need to really upgrade us themselves, and we as a university or the education institute have a lot on our shoulders. So we have reworked our courses, and thanks to the new education policy that has come to India, and according to that, we are working in tandem with the industry. What are their needs and demands? And there are different areas at the moment where we're working on, like robotics, aeronautics, medical, health and care, farming, renewable energy, e-vehicles. Because in every way you talk about, engineering is a part of any business you do today. So our students really need to be geared up for that. And we have tied up with various industries like AWS, Siemens, Upgrad and Microsoft to just upgrade them on the technologies that are available in the market and what they need to, the students really need to do about that. Machine learning, artificial intelligence, data sciences. These are all the areas in which a student has to really look forward for. But at the same time, we do not want a student to become robotics or robots. So they need to really be the think tank behind the need of the hour, and having the classical engineering plus the need of the hour, they should be both parallel, be both in both the studies. So that is what we're looking at.
Okay. Any new courses that you've introduced, any additions to your curriculum in the last one and a half years?
We've introduced a lot of courses, seeing the demand of the industry, especially in the field of machine learning, artificial intelligence, data sciences, and in field of robotics, and also, especially we're coming into e-vehicles also. So that is going to be the trend in the automobile sector. So we have introduced all those courses as a major and minor, where students can choose from in the years that to come by, first year, second year, third year, fourth year, like engineering is for 4 years. So he can choose a lot of courses, and whenever he passes out, so various options are open. He may not be just confined to a subject of artificial intelligence, where machine learning or artificial intelligence can be used in various areas. So we have kept that in mind specifically, that even if he has to change the sector also, so a student of engineering can always move to sector of agriculture. We have a lot of schools, we have around 12 schools in our university, School of Agriculture, School of Medical Sciences. So being part of the, engineering student, he can always take a minor subject in medical and a minor subject in agriculture. So that there are various options for him for to make a startup or become an entrepreneur or to join an industry.
Okay. How about placements? How have they been? Have they been affected adversely because of the, the pandemic, or is there interest in hiring even now? Is that something that you've experienced?
I think opportunities are more, because during the pandemic, many people, we've seen that a lot of jobs have gone by. But at the same time, students have a lot of opportunities. But yes, there have been few takers in this pandemic. And at the same time, the technology is the major area where, you know, there are a lot of hiring is required there. And I'm very happy to say that almost 90% of students have got placements. But yes, many of them have not joined due to pandemic or the personal reasons, or due to that they could not travel, where certain, in especially in the field of mechanical or civil, like automobile sector, they was to go and join the industry. So their parents have their own reservations, but I'm very glad that at least every one of them had the opportunity to join the industry. But I think post COVID, again, there'll be a huge requirement coming by.
So how about salaries, salary packages?
Salaries dependency depends from person to person. There have been a package of from 30 lakh per annum to a package of say 4 lakh per annum. So that really depends on the caliber of the student to student. And there are many students who don't want to travel actually. So those people who really look forward to traveling and going ready to go move towards south or west, the salaries are good there. But at the same time, there are students who are looking for the local vicinity. Then there are options are less. So it really depends on the person to person, how open they are, and it's late.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Gupta. We wish your students the very best. We do hope India is known for its engineering students across the world. So we wish you the very best. Thank you very much.
Satyabhama Institute of Science and Technology, Chennai.